Would you eat meat or seafood created in a lab? Some Bay Area startups are racing now to fill your plates. We wanted to know, does it really taste like the real thing?
And that's what Alan Martin went to find out in a story you'll see only on CBS 13.
At the Folsom Street Foundry south of Market, they were packed in like sardines. But many came for the shrimp.
It actually tasted good.
It's actually quite delicious.
I thought that the shrimp was fantastic.
The event, Indie Bio Demo Day. It's where biotech startups strut their stuff in front of hipsters, investors, and journalists. In this year's batch, two new food companies with a radical idea to grow meat and seafood in a lab.
We're talking about meat that's real meat that's grown from meat cells, whether they're from pigs, cows, or chickens.
No more feedlots, no more animal slaughter, no more overfishing, no more fish farms.
Animal-free, vegan, kosher, gluten-free, but shrimp that looks, tastes, and feels just like shrimp.
Dominique Barnes is the CEO of New Wave Foods. Her team analyzed shrimp on a molecular level to understand how the crustacean's muscle forms that creates a distinct texture.
When you eat shrimp, there's many different things you experience, like a firmness, a brittleness, a juiciness.
Using only certain plants and algae.
Here we have a sample of our shrimp.
The team engineered a new plant-based shrimp. Barnes says it's just as nutritious, but far more sustainable than wild shrimp, the number one consumed seafood in the U.S.
Our oceans are quickly becoming depleted.
Sustainability is also on the minds of those behind Memphis Meats.
We wanted to first make meat that's delicious, that's better for us, also better for the environment, as well as for the animals.
Cardiologist Dr. Uma Valetti is CEO of the company. He explained how his team takes a small sample of cells from a cow, a pig, or a chicken, adds nutrients, and then cultivates the cells into meat, like this meatball, cooked and sampled in this promotional video.
It tastes like a meatball. It's good.
Once their technology evolves, their goal?
That we could actually grow a fillet in 2 weeks or 3 weeks, instead of growing a whole animal that might take 6 months or a year.
Valetti says his meat will be free of antibiotics and pathogens, and may even appeal to vegans.
It could be for people who frankly became vegetarians or vegans because they did not want to support animal cruelty.
Both companies got a big financial boost from IndieBio, a Silicon Valley accelerator.
We're willing to take a risk on something that's completely new and unproven just because we think it has a huge impact.
The New Wave team already has a big order from Google for its cafeterias and expects to ship shrimp to supermarkets as early as this year. Memphis Meats hopes to bring its meat to market in about 5.
Fascinating and scary all at once.
Yes.
So the cost, let's get to that. Both Memphis Meats and New Wave Foods believe that their products will be cost competitive with traditional meat and seafood already on the market. So quite a development.